Hi, welcome to the video, An Introduction to Apache Pinot. A little bit about me, I am Neha Pawar. I am a committer and PMC on the Apache Pinot project. Apache Pinot was developed by engineers at LinkedIn and Uber and is now used by these companies and many others to power a wide variety of user-facing analytics. Apache Pinot is a distributed data store that gives you ultra-low latency, high throughput, user-facing analytics on real-time data. Now that was a lot of big buzzwords. To understand this better, let's spend a day in the life of you, a developer, and your customer, Dave. You have built an amazing application that gives restaurants a platform to display their menus, receive orders online, and gather reviews from their diners. One such restaurant is Dave's Pizzeria. Dave loves your platform as he gets visibility to a lot more customers. Dave is especially excited about today as it's Friday evening and that's when he does the best business. Little did Dave know, a problem was waiting to happen today, which would completely destroy Dave's service. A popular pizzeria in the same area had shut down, driving all pizza cravers from that area to Dave's pizzeria. More the traffic, more the orders. Isn't that a good thing for Dave? Yes, but Dave had no idea he would see a surge in orders today. As the orders started pouring in, his chefs quickly got overwhelmed. His inventory started running out, driving the order turnaround time higher and higher with every order. New customers on the platform saw the inflated wait time, driving many of them away. To make matters worse, the overwhelmed staff resulted in glitches like wrong toppings, missing condiments, and order mix-ups. As Dave tallies up at the end of his service, he's quite surprised when he finds out he's made much less than his Friday evening projection, in spite of what seemed like a burst of orders. That night, Dave logs into the platform for analytical insights. The charts don't reveal any unusual activity. The reason? Your platform has collected all the data from that evening, but the earliest it is made available to him is the next morning. The next morning, Dave checks the platform again. The charts reveal that his turnaround time was much higher compared to usual, and the customer satisfaction had fallen significantly. He also noticed that the traffic on his website was almost twice as compared to usual, right from the beginning of service. That's a strong indicator of an expected increase in order volume for his service. This makes Dave very upset. Had he received this data in the initial few minutes of his service, he could have better forecasted the order volume and made crucial staffing and inventory adjustments to better handle the service. This brings us to an important aspect about the relationship between time and the value of data. Yesterday might be a long time ago for some businesses. Insights are the most valuable to them if they are instant or as close to instant as they can possibly be. This naturally means that as an analytics provider, you can no longer rely simply on the traditional ETL and periodic batch processing jobs to power your analytics. Another aspect that comes up here, analytics is no longer just a thing for business analysts, product managers, and execs. The common users of your applications would also greatly benefit from it. You can build a far more impactful product experience if you can democratize analytics by putting it in the hands of all common users. So what does it take to do this? What does it take to provide analytics of the now and analytics for the all? What sort of system would we need? First off, you start by capturing the now. There's already a bunch of systems built to capture real-time events like Apache Kafka or Amazon Kinesis. Our analytics system needs to be able to connect to such systems and get access to the data from now. Simply having access isn't good enough. To provide instant insights, our system should be able to answer user queries on that now data. Our customers' time is valuable. We want them to have a pleasant experience when interacting with the system. Our system should answer these now data queries in a responsive, interactive, and efficient manner. Putting these analytics in the hands of all would mean we have thousands and thousands of users. Our system should be cut out for high volumes of data and queries. Personalizing analytics for now and for all means that our users should be empowered to query anything and everything they like. Does that sound ambitious and overwhelming? This is where Pinot comes in. Pinot is built to ingest from streams such as Kafka in real time. Pinot indexes the ingested data in real time, maintaining freshness SLAs as low as seconds. Pinot provides ultra-low latency queries, maintaining as low as milliseconds SLAs. Pinot can ingest data with a very high velocity of ingestion, proven to ingest as high as 1 million events per second, while maintaining high throughput for queries, as much as 120K queries per second. Data in Pinot can have extremely high dimensionality and at the same time support ad hoc slice and dice. Pinot has powerful indexes and smart optimizations in routing, data partitioning, segment assignment, server assignment, combined with the rich query set, making it a powerhouse of analytics. Plus, Pinot is a distributed system and comes with high availability, reliability, both horizontal and vertical scalability, and a low cost to serve. Now this definition would make more sense. Pinot is a distributed data store that gives you ultra-low latency, high-throughput, user-facing analytics on real-time data. Pinot will help you build a rich analytics ecosystem for your customers and help them succeed by putting the power of instant insights into their hands. Now you must be wondering, hey, how is this different to using Elasticsearch? Can I just use Presto? Do I need this if I'm already using a key value store? Is this a data warehouse? First off, Pinot is not a data warehouse. Pinot is highly optimized for ultra-low latency, high-throughput analytics involving heavy arbitrary slicing and dicing. And data warehouses are not designed for such kinds of ingestion capabilities, query loads, or latency SLAs. Systems like Presto or BigQuery offer tremendous flexibility and rich query sets, but they can only promise latency SLAs of seconds and cannot be used for interactive user-facing analytics. Elasticsearch and similar search-based systems are typically optimized for free text search. They heavily rely on inverted indexes and have rigid query plans because they need to simply get matching documents and are not optimized to scan all, aggregate, or group by on the documents. To achieve arbitrary slice and dice equivalent to Pinot in key value stores like Kylin or Cassandra, you would have to pre-compute every possible combination and keep doing so every time you added new dimensions, resulting in loss of flexibility and explosive storage. Now coming back to your platform and Dave, that was not a completely hypothetical story. It was actually inspired by one of Pinot's most successful adoption stories, UberEats Restaurant Manager. Uber created UberEats Restaurant Manager, a comprehensive analytics dashboard that enables the owner of a restaurant to get insights from UberEats orders regarding customer satisfaction, popular menu items, sales, and service quality analysis. Pinot enables slicing and dicing the raw data in different ways and supports low latency queries to build a rich experience for the restaurant owner. Now Dave can instantly know the pulse of his service at any time. He can instantly access signals such as increase in eyeballs, thus better forecasting expected increase in order volumes, and prepare Dave's pizzeria for a successful Friday evening service. UberEats Restaurant Manager is one example of many. There are tons of other interesting and innovative applications which use Pinot to build a rich analytics ecosystem for their users. Let's talk about LinkedIn. Apache Pinot project originally started at LinkedIn in 2014 and is now the de facto system for all online analytics needs of the social media giant. Across LinkedIn, Pinot powers more than 70 products, serving queries at over 120K queries per second, while maintaining stringent SLAs of a few milliseconds to subseconds. If you've ever been on LinkedIn.com, you have most probably already interacted with Pinot in the backend. Pinot powers LinkedIn's iconic Who Viewed My Profile application, where you can glance at all your profile views as fresh as a few seconds ago, slice and dice them by dimensions such as company, job title, and location. If you create a post on LinkedIn, the platform will show you analytics of your post, giving you insights into your post's reach, grouped by company, location, and job titles of the viewers. Another great example of delivering real-time data with actionable insights using Pinot is LinkedIn's Talent Insights. This is a tool that helps organizations understand the external labor market and their internal workforce by providing access to LinkedIn's economic graph, which consists of 690 million members, 36,000 skills, 50 million companies, and 90,000 schools. Through mapping every member, company, job, and school, Talent Insights can help users answer questions like, what is the fastest growing skill in the software industry? Which schools did company X's employees graduate from? Users can further explore the data by filtering on various dimensions like geographic locations, member skills, and member titles. Pinot is also used at LinkedIn for impression discounting, a technique used to determine the items to recommend to a user based on historical engagement. And the most familiar example of this would be your LinkedIn feed items. Along with all these stellar user-facing real-time analytics applications, Pinot also stores all of LinkedIn's business metrics, which is over 10,000 metrics with over 50,000 dimensions. There's another system called Third Eye, a self-serve platform for anomaly detection and root cause analysis, where users can set alerts on their business metrics, and the system will then trigger an alert whenever there is a deviation in that metric. Across LinkedIn, Third Eye is monitoring over 100,000 time series for anomalies, and there's over 50 teams using this. Third Eye is also open source and very well integrated with Pinot. There's loads of other companies also using Pinot, such as Weibo, Factual, Slack, Microsoft Teams, Confluera, Publicis Sapient, City Storage Systems, and many more. Now imagine what you could do for your customers using Pinot. You could use Pinot in e-commerce to collect all events related to your orders and provide real-time insights to sellers about demand and inventory, which can help them with forecasting and dynamic pricing. You could also use Pinot to analyze code repository activity to extract insights about developer productivity, project popularity, skills, popular libraries, and review efficiency for your organization. You could use Pinot in the IoT space, from monitoring the health of machines on the floor and operational efficiency in industrial IoT, to instant insights about crop health, soil, temperature, moisture in agricultural IoT, the possibilities are tremendous. In financial tech, you can analyze real-time transaction data and enrich the digital banking experience with personalized analytics. Impression discounting and other recommendation techniques can be applied in real time to deliver fresh recommendations of articles, music, products to all your users. Pinot can help with real-time monitoring and anomaly detection for alerting systems. The possibilities are endless. That's it from me. We hope you enjoyed this video. You'll find our documentation at pinot.apache.org. Find us on Medium at Apache Pinot for blogs and recipes. We'd love to hear from you and welcome you to join our community Slack channel. You'll find the link for that in the description below. We're also on Twitter at Apache Pinot and would love to get connected. Thanks.